I don't know. I'm not getting anything from you people. Okay, however, let me continue the class here. So we have already seen, this particular control structure. The control structure might be, so if else, and then so ladder if, I mean, let me say else if ladder, then followed by nested if. Okay, nested if. All these things have been seen in the previous class. And today, we'd like to write some number of programs and also have some assignments for our next class. So however, you could see. So write a program to find the given number is even or odd. I have framed approximately some 7 to 8 programs here. So these are the different kinds of programs which are available with us. So I'd like to explain one by one in a sequential order. Let me take this particular program. So in a sequential order here, even or odd. So let us do the programs here. So let me open this one. Yeah. So here will be equal to. Any number followed by if so a is a modulus of 2 even or odd, yes, modulus of 2 will be equal to 0, then so print a is an even number. Okay. Otherwise, print A is an odd number. Okay. Simply speaking, writing of programs is very, very, very simple here. So save this particular program. Okay, run this particular program. You could see something like some 23. It is an odd number. And run again, F5 again. So for example, it is 12. It is even number. Okay, 12 is an even number. Something like this, it's very simple to write this particular program. So writing of this particular program is so second program is this one, that is program to find the character is lowercase or uppercase. So here in C programming, as like as our C programming, so here also we do have methods, some string methods are available. So those methods will be is lower, is upper. Is lower, is upper. So is lower, lower. So that is one particular, some string, whatever the variable you have been taken here, string dot is lower will be always gives you so true or false here. If the string, whatever the string you have been entered, that particular string is lowercase, then obviously it could be returns true. Otherwise it could be returns false here. Similarly, so st dot, so is upper. So is upper also, so returns either true or false here. So if your entered value will be true, I mean uppercase letters, then it could be considered as true. Otherwise, it could be considered as false here. So by using these two different types of string methods, we would like to perform the operation of is upper or let me say this lowercase or uppercase here. Okay, uppercase letter or lowercase letter here. Let us identify this particular thing here. Okay. So let us do this particular kind of thing here. So file new. Let me take one more. Some A will be equal. So here, my internet connection is not that much good, so that is why this many number of times connection and disconnection was happened here. So however, str will be equal to st will be equal to let me say input of, you could take enter a string. Okay. Then followed by, so if, so st dot is lower, then what shall we have to consider? So print st comma is a lowercase letter. Otherwise, st is uppercase letter. Uppercase letter. Okay. A very simple program here. Very simple program. Lawyer.py. Lawyer.python. Let us run this particular program for a while. So let me take small a. So small a is a lowercase letter, and let me run one more time. Let me run one more time for this particular program. Right now it is a cap. So it is uppercase letter. So look at this. So you could have, these are the two methods which are very much useful to identify whether given character is lowercase or uppercase here. Lowercase or uppercase. One is lower, will be always true if you are really given the input as lowercase. Is upper is always true when your given value is in uppercase. Okay. So in that way, so it is going to be, gets identified here. Okay. So this is the way to get the specification. I will send all these things through Google Classroom. Don't worry. So this is the next program what we are interested here. And next one is the program to identify whether you have entered a vowel or consonant. So to identify this particular program, identify to this particular program, vowels in the sense A, E, I, O, U. We know very well. A, E, so I, O, U, all these are vowels. Other than these, so other than these characters, out of 26 characters, so if you omit these five characters, whatever the character you have entered, that could be called as a consonant here. So therefore, we would like to write a small program for this particular thing here also. Let us take one more control N. So let us take some ST. ST equal to input of enter a character, whatever the character you are interested. Yes, you can take the character. If, I'd like to introduce here the logical operators. If, so ST is equal to A, I'm trying to check it out only for lowercase letters, or so ST. So is equal to E, or so ST will be equal to I, or ST will be equal to So go or so ST will be equal to U. Either of these. Okay, not exactly all, either of these. Either of these in the sense probably A, probably E, probably I, probably O, and probably U. Either of these characters will be there with you. Then obviously you could consider that. So that is a vowel. So therefore print. So ST, comma, is a vowel. Is a vowel. Otherwise, things will not be taken into consideration, then what exactly we would like to consider here else, so is a consonant. It is a consonant. If you are not supposed to take the values A, E, I, Y, U, something like this, obviously it could be considered as the consonant here, yeah? Screen is shared only. The screen is under sharing mode, yeah? The screen is already under sharing mode. Screen is already under sharing mode. Yes, let me share one more time. Yes, it is right now, it is under sharing mode only. Yes, it is. Screen is already under sharing mode. Okay. So either of. So if ST will be equal to A or ST will be equal to E or I or O or U, any one of these. Already we have seen in the previous sessions, we have seen already where exactly these are. Yes, the logical operators. You could see these logical operators. All these logical operators could be specified that. So R operation will be always taken when all operations will be, all expressions will be give false, only the output will be give false. Otherwise the output, so output will be so true only. So either of one particular expression will be gives true, obviously the entire logical R will be gives you true here. So that is what you need to consider. That is what you need to remember here. So based on this one, either of this particular condition will be gets true. The entire expression will be, entire R expression will be gives true only. So that is why you could get vowel. Otherwise it is cancelled. Let me run for a while this one. So the program name is, so vowel.py, vowel.python. So let me run this particular point here. So let me enter A. A in the sense it is a vowel. And let me run one more time. Let me run one more time for a while. So let me see, this is B. Okay, let us consider this is B here. B is a consonant because it is not equal to any one of the so characters what I have specified here. All these conditions will be false, so that is why the if structure will be gives you false. Obviously, it will be goes to the else part here. Okay, so therefore the output will be same in such a way. So this is the way you need to identify. So I hope that these structures are enough to you to explain the information regarding to the what you call if else structures. And very important point we need to remember here. Let me come across. Yeah. So very importantly, we would like to concentrate on this particular program. Of course, you could perform at our own. So of this one, write a program to check whether the given number is so positive or negative or zero. You could take this particular kind of thing here. That is, you could write this particular program at our own and write a program so to find biggest among four numbers. Let me show you how this could be biggest among four numbers. Let me show you. I would like to say, see you. So first number is A, second number is B, third number is C, and fourth number is D. For example, these are the four numbers. Now let me consider that if A is greater than B and A is greater than C and A is greater than this is C, A is greater than D. If all these conditions will be true, then A will be the biggest. A will be the biggest. Otherwise, if this is not the case, we will conclude that A could not be the biggest. Of course, it might be minimum or not. It doesn't matter, but it is not the maximum value. Therefore, we would like to compare. So these three here. These three in the sense of B is greater than C. So and B is greater than D. If this will be true, then B will be the biggest. And this will be gets false in the sense C is greater than D. Then this will be true. C will be the biggest. Either of conditions will be false. Obviously, we could consider that D will be the biggest. Let us write the program for a while. Then you could understand very easily. So look at this. So A equal to integer of input. So enter a number. Okay. Enter your number. Let me copy for a while for the 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Four values. This is B, this is D, and this is A, B, C, D. Okay, this is D here. I'd like to take all these values as input here. After taking input, what exactly we are trying to check out here? If so, A is greater than B, A is greater than B, and A is greater than C, so and A is greater than D. If all these conditions will be true, for example, all these conditions will be true, then obviously what shall we have to consider here? In the sense, so print so A comma is biggest value. A is biggest value. Okay. Otherwise, if this is not the true value, this is not true. For example, either of these conditions will be true, then obviously we could consider this entire thing will be gets false. Obviously, we would like to consider that A could not be the biggest value. Then what else will be biggest value in the sense? You have to make one more. So my internet connection is not that much good. Tomorrow, by tomorrow itself, I would like to make it possible. So by tomorrow, I would like to make it possible. However, let me complete this particular point today. So else, so actually, else if actually, we would like to consider this particular thing here. So if else ladder, else if ladder, or if else ladder. So let us take the point here. So let us take this particular point here. So ELIF, else if, so B is greater than C, and so B is greater than D. If this is true, then what exactly we would like to consider here is, so B will be the biggest among all. Okay. So if it is also not true, then what exactly we would like to consider here? So ELIF, else if what exactly we would like to consider here is C is greater than D, then so we would like to consider C will be the biggest among all. Okay. If all the conditions will be false, then what exactly we would like to consider here? Print the final value, that is D, which is biggest value. Otherwise, so remaining all will be considered as not biggest values. Okay, this is the problem. So like to save at a particular place. Yes. big4.py, biggest4.py. Let me run this particular thing for a while. Okay, let me take, so enter a number, so that is 2. Then 5, then 7, and then 1. 7 is the biggest value. Yes, this particular value is the biggest value. So likewise, you could check it out. So which is the biggest value to write, to identify. So among four numbers, what is the biggest value? Yes, you could identify in such a way. You could identify in such a way. Okay. This is the way to identify whether a given number will be biggest or not. Okay. And very importantly, we'd like to consider this particular thing. This is very important point, because this kind of programs will be gives you come to your final examinations also. So to find the grade of the student, so let us take this particular program. For writing this particular program, we need to have student ID is the first input, and student name is the second input, and the third input will be so subject 1 mark, subject 2 marks, and so on up to so subject 6 marks. 6 subject marks are required. All these things will be considered as input here. All these are input here. So then the process will be so we need to identify the total marks. Total marks will be identified. We need to identify the average marks, and then followed by identify the grade. What is the grade which is being acquired or secured by that particular student here? This is under processing. This is process. And finally, output will be student ID, so student name, and then total marks, and then average, and then grade. So these must be produced by you. Okay. In this way, you have to identify this one. For this particular point, we'd like to follow all these rules and regulations. So let me copy all these rules and regulations into our program. So because we would like to follow same kind of things in our program only. Yeah, let me take it out. Okay, let me take one more. Yeah. So look at this. SID, student ID, will be equal to input of enter student ID. Yes, student ID has been taken. So student name, so input of enter student name. Yes, name has been taken. Then followed by SUB1 will be equal to input of, okay, it is actually integer, so int of input of, so enter subject 1 marks. Okay, subject 1 marks. Yes, it has been. Let me copy for a while for 6 times. Yes, it could be taken. So this is subject 1, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, subject 5, and subject 6. And of course, here also we have to change here, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, subject 5, and subject 6. Yes, we have taken in such a way. Already input is gets over. Everything is gets over. Now what exactly we need to identify here is, we need to identify so the total of the student. So yes, TOT, student total, will be equal to SUB1 plus SUB2 plus whatever the subject marks you have been entered. So all subject marks will be added together. SUB3 plus SUB4 plus SUB5 plus SUB6. You can name your own subject names, Telugu, English, something like that. Otherwise, M1, M2, something like that. You have take your own. Okay. SUB6. Yes, subject 6 only. SUB6 only. I have entered properly. SUB1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, it is. Okay. Subject 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Obviously, after taking all these, then SAVG, student average, will be equal to student total divided by 6, because 6 subjects. Now the condition grade will becomes into this particular area. Okay, grade will becomes this particular area. Let us look into this matter. If SUB 1 is less than 40, so they have asked that if any one of the subjects will be less than 40, then grade will be false. Otherwise, grade will be something else. OSABCD. Okay, if subject 1 is less than 40, so subject 2 is less than 40, or subject 3 is less than 40, or subject 4 is less than 40, or subject 5 is less than 40, or subject 6 is less than 40. Either of these conditions will be satisfied. Any one of the conditions will be satisfied. He will be put into fail. So therefore, final grade will be, so S grade, G-R-A-D, S grade will be equal to the capital F. Okay. Else if this is not the case, then we need to identify either he may be secured. So O grade, S grade, A, B, C, D. For this particular reason, we'd like to consider. So yes, student average A, B, G is greater than or equal to 40. And so I'll come from the bottom. So from the bottom, I'll come. So yes, A, B, G is less than or equal to 49. If this is the case, then what else we have to consider? Yes. Student grade will be equal to D. So then I'd like to copy this one because to save the time, I'd like to copy this one here. If SABC is greater than or equal to 50 and so less than or equal to 59, so he may be secure. What is the 59 in the sense C? So he may be secure, capital C. And 60 to 69, so he may be secure. He may be secure B. So, okay, capital B. 70 to 79, he may be secured, capital A. Okay, 70 to 79, capital A. So, ELIF, so S, A, B, G is greater than or equal to, so 80, and S, ABG is less than or equal to 89, then it may be SABG is equal to ABC. This is actually A. And he got S here. He got S grade. Otherwise, all the conditions will be gets failed. So SABG, it is S grade. So therefore, S grade, if all the conditions will be failed, it may be get O, outstanding. Okay, it may be get O. Okay, these are not required at this moment. Okay, so he got this much. Yes, procedure is gets over. All process, whatever the process you are required, yes, everything has been. We have been identified total, we have been identified average, and how grade will be segregated. Yes, everything is being identified here. So finally, what exactly we have to do? Produce the output. So therefore, so print student ID, so comma SID. Okay. Then followed by print, so student name. Name of the student will be yes name. Okay. Then followed by print. So total marks. Total marks will be, so how much STOT, student total. Okay. Then followed by, so print, so average marks will be comma SAVG, student average. Then followed by print, finally print. So grade secured, secured grade will be, so SGRADE. So let me check it out whether things will be properly taken or not here. So S grade, everything is okay. Yes, let me run out this particular program. First of all, save this particular program with the names. So grade.py, student grade.py. Let me run out this particular program for a while. So let me ask you student ID first. Student ID will be 501. Student name, some name. Okay, Hari. Subject one marks, some 67, however, whatever the marks it might be. So you please enter some number of marks. So look at this. Student ID will be, so 501, name is Hari, and 447 is the total marks he was secured, and average will be 74.5. So therefore he got A grade. So this is the output. For doing this particular whole business, so we have written something like this. So this is else if ladder, completely else if ladder. Okay, else if ladder will be taken into consideration, something like this. Okay, in this way you have to complete the if structures, and I will forward everything to Google Classroom. Hope that everybody is available with the Google Classroom. Still people are not available with the Google Classroom, so send our email address, I will invite you. Therefore, you could get whatever the stuff I have prepared or we have discussed, everything will be comes through Google Classroom only. Okay? So this is the way you have to write the decision making structures, which are if family. If family in the sense if else, else if ladder, nested if. Okay? All these things will be comes into picture in such a way. Okay? So by tomorrow, I'd like to set up my complete internet connection. And tomorrow onwards, we could not have any disturbance while doing some kind of, taking some kind of classes like this year. Okay. Because right now I'm in Machala. So in Machala, some problem will be there. So I do identify and I will fix out this particular problem by tomorrow. Okay. So your attendance will be sent out to your attendance, please place the previous class topic in the, okay. I'll place it. There is no problem. I'll place it. Okay. Your attendance will be sent out to the university today. So I'd like to take the entire attendance today, and I'll mark up everything with your roll numbers by taking this particular thing, and I'll take the printout. Yeah. Okay. So today onwards, your attendance will be sent out to university, and at the end of this particular class or end of this particular semester, if your attendance could not be up to 75 marks, 75%, you could not be promoted to next semester. Okay. Please remember and try to inform the same to everybody. Okay. Thank you.